biggest ones that I stop people doing is they get excited about new build houses. And they get excited about the figures that new build companies will put across. So back, well, God, it's 15 years ago now, before Cardiff Bay and Cardiff was really, you know, on the up and taking off, a bit like all of our cities in the UK, where, you know, we're basically looking at massive growth, you know, all the bays are developed and all of that's done, and everyone's going, oh, these apartments, they're going to be amazing, you know, the figures are really good. And of course, all that's happened is the market's been flooded with the same product. So there are a lot of people back then when I was buying my little houses up the valleys, which I'll show you one day. I've got one that I bought for 19,000. People are going, oh no, you don't want to be doing that, those are, you know, horrible little houses up in the valleys, you want to be doing, you know, these new build apartments. The reality is, no, you don't, because you've just flooded the market with the same product, and the price dropped by about half.
Really?
When the crash came. Oh yeah.
Oh really?
So new. So if you bought then, if you bought after the crash, great. But they got hit so hard with the crash, but also because they were new builds, so the price is inflated anyway. People were buying apartments in Cardiff and Cardiff Bay for like 200,000, and then couldn't shift them on for 100. And the house sellers were selling them off to housing associations to get rid of them as well. Whereas the houses that I was buying up in the valleys, they might have dropped by 1,000 or 2,000. You know, they were 50,000 and they might have gone down to 45, but they've recovered since and going up. These apartments in Cardiff, I'm not actually sure whether they've completely recovered yet. But I wouldn't want to be involved anyway, because you've also then got, you, when you buy an apartment or a flat in a block, you enter into a massive joint venture with another load of buyers that you don't even know. So when the roof needs redoing or any major maintenance needs doing, what are you going to do? You've either, if you've got a good management company in place and all the rest of it, fine, but I wouldn't like to be an owner of some of those apartments in, say, 20 years' time when, you know, stuff starts going wrong. The roof starts failing, or, you know, the hoarding on the outside, well, it was already discolouring within a couple of years, never mind 20. So it's knowing about what works, and a lot of people who get into property, they want it to look really glamorous. They don't want to deal with a 20 grand house up in the valleys that's wrecked, that needs gutting, that's just, you know, dirty work. They want to buy a nice brand new apartment and think of all the money they'll make. It's just not true. You can't buy all of that benefit of no hassle without some kind of cost. And unfortunately, for a lot of people who did that back then, they're still in negative equity now, because there was also, you know, mortgage availability at 95%.